you guys should come in practice. You should not have our interruption in between your any of the this GD or PI round. So what I again will do it today. I would like maybe the Rimjim ma'am or maybe the Naveen sir, any one of you can make the list and we'll follow the list. Make sure you try to speak within 1-1.5 minutes. Later on, we'll give you 2 minute, 3 minute time also. Remember, we started with 15 second, 30 second, now more than a minute. So why more than a minute time only? Why not 2-3 minutes? So you can speak to the point. You should not go beyond the point. Sometimes when we speak and those things are or maybe it's keep repeating. That should not be. All right? It's clear? Raise your hand.
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Fine? Okay. And I hope you all are doing good. So, Naveen sir, please make the list and give them.
Today, can we go in alphabetical order of name?
Yeah, it's fine. It's a good idea.
Okay, so first Anshika, then Arijit, Divya,
okay.
Hridya. Then today we can see 2-3 new participants, Vishakha, Shivam.
Naveen sir, Shivam is a new student for the next year batch. He's here just as a spectator to listen to what is happening so he can get a hang of it, okay?
Okay, okay.
Okay.
So we can start with Anshika, then Arijit, then Divya and Hridya. You can start. Meanwhile, I'll make the list.
Hello, everyone. My band topic is Titan. Every 3 seconds, someone in the world buys a Titan. Like the world's fifth largest watch manufacturer commenced business in 1984 in Chennai with the name Titan Watches Limited with a tagline, Be More. It is a joint venture between Tata Group and Tamil Nadu Development Corporation. The initial position of the Titan was durable yet stylish, which convinced customers to switch over mechanical watches. Initially, Titan leveraged with Tata brand to build trust and reliability. The unique production and marketing strategy of Tata is good service, good pricing, and good variety of collection. Tata follows a multi-brand strategy with brands like Tanishq, Tanera, Fast Track, Joya, and Gold Plus, etc. Thank you.
Thank you, Anshika.
Okay, next, Arijit.
Good evening, everyone. Today, I'm going to speak about the luxury brand Allen Solly. So Allen Solly was first founded in the year 1744 by William Hillon and Company Limited. Then it was bought by an Indian brand called the Madura Garments and Company Limited. Then in 2001, it was acquired by Aditya Birla Group. Allen Solly was the modernizer in bringing the semi-formal modernization and revolt in the Indian market. Recently, it introduced ikat shirts in the menswear, which was in a great trend. So ikat is a legendary hand weaving technique from the Pochampalli rainbands itself. This brand came with a great idea in the Indian market called the Friday dressing. So it launched its office apparel in colored shirts and khaki pants, which also became a prom hit fashion. It also in the year of 2002 was the first Indian brand which introduced the work fashion for women. In 2013, it expanded its complete kidswear, and in the year 2014, it launched its jeans company called the Solly Jeans Company. It's the brand ambassador of Ellen Solly is Indrani Dasgupta, and the logo is a reindeer. The tagline of this company is My World, My Way. And as we all know that in the recent years, in the recent and also in the present, social media has a great impact in our lives. So the Ellen Solly has a great influence in social media. In Instagram, it has about 13.6K followers. In Twitter, Arigit, it has about 16.6K followers.
Arigit, you have taken more than 2 minutes. So I would like to stop you here.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, next, Divya.
Hello, everyone. Today, I would like to tell about Tata Group. Tata Group founded by Jamshedji Tata in 1868. It is running so many sectors. For example, telecom, hospitality, finance, and automotive, steel, retail, etc. At the age of 29, Jamshedji Tata worked in his father's companies. In 1870, with 21,000 capitals, he founded a trade company. Then he started his business slowly. He dreamed of achieving focus, setting up into iron steel company, a Unique Hotel, a learning institution, and a hydroelectronic plants. That four goals are achieved. First one, Taj Mahal Hotel in 903. Tata Steel 1903, Tata Power 1910, and then Dream Indian Institute of Science 1911. So finally, Tata Group, they give 66% in his share income. They give charitable trusts and another trusts. So thank you. Thank you, sir.
Salni, what was the topic we had?
Sir, it was in fashion. It was a luxury brand, sir.
You said brand. And what we have spoke like just now?
Not Salni.
Study about the Tata.
It was not me, sir. It was not Divya. Me.
Oh, sorry. Okay, yeah. Divya.
Yes.
Divya, you're not aware about the topic?
One brand.
Nothing to worry. Do you aware about the topic, what we are supposed to do it today or not?
And listen and learn Tata Group totally. So it's my mistake.
Okay. No, it was good. You have spoke well. I really appreciate. You have improved also. Okay. But any individual, if you're having any doubt, it's not for you only. I'm saying for everybody. You can please contact so that I can clear your doubt. Yesterday, Arjit has a doubt. Sir. He contacted me and today he spoke well. He called me thrice. I was on another call. Meanwhile, I was in another class. He called me at 5, then 5:30. Twice I've given him time, 6:30 you contact me. Again, he called me back by 6:30. So please call and clear your doubt if you have. Okay?
Okay, sir.
But it was good while speaking.
Okay.
Yeah, you have improved really a lot. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you,
okay, next, Hridaya, Mayank and Pranav.
Hridaya, it's your turn now.
Next.
Mayank.
After it, Mayank, yeah. Yeah, Mayank. Start.
Good evening, sir. Today I'm going to talk about the luxury fashion brands today. Here's a brand logo of it. So, Supreme is a is established in 1964 in America, New York. The founder name is James Jeppy. And it was earlier a skateboarding brand. It used to make skateboards. And then it started with the clothing, accessories, shoes, shirts. And then it collaborated with Louis Vuitton in 2017. And also collaborated with Hennes, our t-shirt brand, for making premium and particularly line for t-shirts and boxers. It also got an award from the Association of American Designers in 2018 for the best clothing brand. So that's it. Thank you.
Okay, next, Pranav.
Hi, I'm speaking on a brand called Peter England. It has been acquired by ABFRL Group in the year 2000. Peter England and brand is the number one mid-segment brand, which has formal wear, casual wear, business formals, accessories like ties, belts, shoes, and also it has launched a new collection in the deodorants. This brand has having a turnover of around 1,000 crores. It is a growth path of the 15% year on year. It focuses on mid-youth and the youth, which is an age group between 20 to 30. It focuses on three major categories of the garments, which is more into sustainability, fashion, and fusion. They also launched a sub-brand called Red by Peter England, which is for Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. And the next important part is it is having great partnerships, like it has been sponsored for CSK, for IPL, Ministry of Textile for Handloom, and KVIC for Khadi. Thanks.
Okay, next, Sanchita.
So I'm talking about a luxury brand called Dior, which was introduced in by Christian Dior in 1946. Its headquarters is in Paris. And their first collection was basically called New Look, which was concentrating on feminine designs, and it made it very glamorous. It also sells many retail, other than retail, it sells jewelry and then cosmetics and also skincare as well. And another specialty is that they have very intricate designs, and they have in every collection, they have their own silhouette. And right now they're one of the go-to leading luxury brands for royal family and other Hollywood celebrities as well. And Jennifer Lawrence is one of the most, ambassador right now. And they have very iconic collections, such as the social movement collection right now, which is being done on feminism, and also their evening gowns collection, and also their Italian flair collection. And also right now their net worth is around $43 billion, and their Chinese economy e-commerce market has been up the game. And they basically make limitless items rather than concentrating on seasonal items, which makes it so iconic in the fashion industry. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Shalini, Shivangi, Shreya, next.
Hello.
Yes.
Shalini, you're audible. Continue.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm going to talk about Kinzo Paris, sir.
Yeah, okay. Start your topic.
Kinzo is a French luxury brand, sir, which was being founded in 1970 by a Japanese designer. And he is known for his Asian and then Japanese influence in the construction of the French European fashion, sir. And the leading designers of this brand is Pinzo Olivia Battista, and it has its hands on even in the skincare products and even the perfume. And very recently, in 1993, this brand was being taken by the LVMH, which is the Louis Vuitton. And that's it, sir. I just want to talk about the leading designers of this brand, who are Kinzo Tadaka and Carol Lynn and Antino. And it has even collaborated with H&M in 2016 and Iglad Cosmetics in the year 2011, sir. That's it.
Okay. Next, Shivangi.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to speak on the brand H&M. It is a Swedish multinational clothing retail company, which is also known for its fast fashion clothing for men, women, teenagers, and kids. Presently, it operates in 74 countries with over 5,000 stores. In India, it has 42 stores and is set to cross about 50 stores this year. And it is the second largest global clothing retailer, just behind Zara. It offers its brand through COS, Weekday, Monki, Cheap Monday, and H&M Home. It has also has reported a 45% increase in sales in India last year. And this was due to the addition of new stores and aggressive pricing. And it also offers, it is also focusing on sustainability. It has taken few steps to reduce their environmental impact. It uses renewable energy as a part of its supply chain. And its basic concept is to offer fashion and quality at the best price in a sustainable way. Thank you.
Good. Next, Shreya.
Shreya is not there. Next, you can ask the next name.
Vishakha.
Shreya has messaged me proper.
Vishakha.
I think Vishakha also having a network issue. Shreya texted me, she is having a network issue.
Then I think everybody is done.
Hello?
They are done now? Yeah, who is there?
Sir, I'm Ridhya.
Oh,
Ridhya.
Okay,
there.
Yeah, please start.
Hi, sir, I would like to talk about the Chanel brand. My it's Coco Chanel. Coco Chanel is a luxury brand which is originated in France, and it was started in 1909 by Coco Chanel. Started with a hat, like she started selling hats, and then she slowly she partnered with Pierre. She started selling, getting into luxury products, as well as they started the ready-to-wear collection. They're also into the hot couture, and now it is the Chanel brand is owned by the grandsons of Pierre with Widerman, which is Elian with Widerman and Gerard Widerman. And they're the company in the 1920s. Chanel was famous for its it has which was considered to be the stereotype, the regular bodies of women clothing. They changed, they revolutionized it, and they changed it to a more comfortable and more ready to wear affordable price of clothing. They're also famous for their LBD, that is a little black dress, which was a comfortable clothing for females. They actually changed the tight-fitting corsets, tight-fitting gowns into a more comfortable lineage, into a mini skirt. So they actually changed the thinking of women, like more of who wears a pink or something. They changed it to a more bold colors, like gray was used, navy blue was used for their dresses. So that they had a minimum, like maximum contribution in changing the ideology of that time women, so that they can wear the more comfortable clothes. So right now, Chanel is one of the most popular luxury brands, which is into ready to wear They also have their own perfume line, which is the most famous perfume they have is Chanel No. 5, which is used by so many celebrities like Blake Lively, Cameron Diaz, and Beyonce. They're all the brand ambassador. Like, they all wear the Chanel brand. And they also have a very cult fashion. They have the Chanel suit, which became famous in the 1920s. It was a woolen skirt with a jacket, and they made it a revolutionary dress. Also, the LBD,
Naveen sir, are you there?
Yes.
So time limit was there something?
Time is done.
It's done. Okay. It is used as a very good product. I would like to come.
Shalini, time, your time is done.
Okay.
Sorry, Hridya.
Yeah.
I think Shreya is here. You can tell her to start. I think she has joined.
Shreya, can you hear us?
Hello. Can I continue, sir?
Yes, yes.
Today, speak about started in 1881, Moss Philip and he and his son started selling shirts that was worn by his wife and daughter. And kids wear. Also, it includes sports. And the CEO of the company is the region New York in USA. The brand ambassador, this brand is nice property. The logo consists of three letters combination, that is VAH, that is basically Indian brand, but it was found in Ireland. That's
Naveen sir?
Yes.
You please continue.
Yeah, so group feedback. Before that, individual feedback. Arijit, Ellen Solly is not a luxury brand. Okay. Divya, next time you need to understand what is the instruction and you have to follow this, because you spoke about Tata and complete Tata, we didn't expect this. Otherwise, you spoke well. And Sanchita, don't close your eyes while you are speaking.
Yeah, okay, sir.
Okay. Shalini, don't use sir. Whenever you are speaking, in between you use sir. This is not required.
Okay, sir. Okay.
And Mayank and Shreya, you need to check your internet connection, because yesterday also and today also there was connectivity problem.
Yes, sir. Next time we'll take care.
Yeah, Krishna sir.
Yeah, I would like to go to, like, you know, Akhilesh sir and the Rimjim ma'am to give a feedback. If Nidhi ma'am is audible, even her feedback we'll take, and then we'll conclude. Akhilesh sir.
Yeah, so coming to Pranav. Pranav spoke very well on pitching land. Pranav and Sanchita, so their consistency was good. You guys were very confident while speaking. Coming to Shalini. You could have chosen a different brand. Lot of people went on about talking about history, about the formation of the brand, which actually is irrelevant. So what you can do is, instead of going to history, which actually is a lot of people are not interested in, try to get their latest collection or what their revenue model is, what they have been used for recently. For instance, Shivangi talked about sustainability in terms of H&M, right? So that's quite a good point. All right, similarly, other brands also are moving, taking some steps. So what recent steps they have taken? So those kind of things you can, put in your talk when you're talking about a certain brand. All right. Okay. Hridaya talked about Chanel. She talked very well, Hridaya. All right. There could have been more content and clarity about the brand. And Dibya, I said, you have to select a brand, not a group of companies. All right. The rest of we are good. That's all from me.
Okay, I want to say something. Shreya and Mayank, you need to keep your internet good because we get a notification when your bandwidth is low. So you need to check your internet. I think Anshika spoke well. Hridaya and Pranav spoke well. Shivangi spoke well also. Arjeet, I think most of you spoke well. Also, like Akhilesh sir mentioned, this brand study is not about knowing the numbers like 1970 it was formed in or this number. You need to talk more about the essence of the brand. Like, we have Chumbak in India, so it's made of Indian motifs. That's the essence of the brand. Which customers does it serve? Tier 2 or Tier 3 or Tier 1? What are the price ranges that are there? Are there any designers involved in it, or is it online, offline? So try to add these things rather than, I felt you all have just opened Wikipedia page and, just read it through. Also, people who didn't on their video, we would like you to on the video so that it's obvious that you are not reading and doing it. Okay, so for next time, try to do that and keep the essence of the brand intact, which is like, what is their tagline? What do they stand for? What is the meaning of the brand and all that? That's for me.
Thank you, Rimji ma'am.
One feedback for Arijit. Yesterday also I told, when you are speaking, it looks like this is bookish language. So try to speak in your own language.
Okay, sir.
And Pranav talked about turnover and key partnership. That is something you can always account in when you're speaking about a certain brand. What any merger that has happened, okay, what is the turnover, those kind of things. Along with that, as Rinji ma'am said, what's the essence of the brand? That is very, very important. There are three kinds of brands. We have mass brands, premium brands, and luxury brands. Mass brands include like Max, Unlimited People, premium brands such as Van Heusen, Louis Philippe, and when you come to luxury brand, you have Chanel, Gucci, Armani, all these things. Gucci. All right, so these are classifications of the brand. So you should try to point out in which category they fall. Okay, Naveen sir.
Yes, sir. So they had to speak more about brand placement than category, men's, women's, and kids, and then type of collection they have.
Well, so I would start with Shivangi. It's really a good progress, and kind of I'm happy with everyone. Like, you all are yes, doing really good. For day one to I compare here, and we all are beating the problem which we have. It may be the internet or maybe the Wi-Fi and someone from Pune or someone from Assam and all those places. So I would really like, in case if you're not here, able to connect us and give your point, please call and contact me. We'll be always there to guide you. And I'm so happy. I'm so excited to see everyone is participating, trying your best. if even Nidhi ma'am can listen us or can give some point, I would like to take our own opinion, her opinion also. But meanwhile, I would like to say one thing. We are taking it step by step on next level. We are doing it good. So step by step, your progress is good. Overall feedback from the expert is really important, what you need to do. But you have already started working. That is a good sign. So let's start here. The one thing, for Sanchita, try having a good lighting on your face, even though you are in home also. Today, I am also here only. I'm not in Pahal, but still, like, you know, try having a lighting. So when you are sitting there, so it should be the proper visible. So that we can see your body gesture and we can talk about it also. Okay. Because that's a very important, it's a GD round. So avoid having a, in a GD, okay, sir and all word.
Okay.
Because it's in a group. Yeah. Thank you, Sanchita. It's kind of a common. Now, the next, what I want to tell is, Naveen sir, could we do one thing? I want them to prepare for retail, support our e-commerce. These are, okay. Thank you, Sanchita. Naveen sir. They'll have next class on Tuesday. Let's keep session for 1 hour. You will have continuous 1 hour class. And everyone have to speak minimum 2+ minutes or 3 minutes is the limitation. You can opt either e-commerce or export house or retail. So you have to understand the difference between what is the retail market, what is the e-commerce, what is the export house. So opt any one of this. So maybe 3/4 of you having a retail, 3/4 of you talking about export, 3/4 of you talking about e-commerce. So rest of you also will have a better information. And try getting, rather than the common, the how the Rimji ma'am has given you the example, or Akhilesh sir and Naveen sir, to get some information which is more the input from your side for that particular topic. Is that clear? Not just having a primary information, just look for the secondary and in, like, you know, your ideas and conclusion about that information, right? Yes, raise your hand if you guys, like, you know, understand. You don't need to even, like, you know, unmute yourself. Just raise your hand if you understand. If you have doubt also, raise your hand and then unmute and say. Yeah, Naveen sir, yes, is this sir, fine this is or good. Yeah,
in terms so of retail that, I would suggest everyone to take all those retails which is in India. Don't take foreign retailers which they don't have presence in India.
So international brand who even having in India, you can take those also.
You can take, yes.
And make sure, find out this detail. What is export house? What is retail? When I was in my, I think in my placement, yeah, I appeared for Sahi Exports and they were asking about export house and retail, the difference in my GD. And most of them talking about completely out of the box. Like, you know, like how if somebody, if you ask the corona and started singing a song and you started laughing, what is this? So please be specific about the point. Understand the point or else you will not understand. Because later on, you will have a GD topic related to this. So why exports house is like, you know, in India, more than India, in Bangladesh, now in Vietnam and other cities. So going in next level, let's do on a primary level research. What is export, retail and e-commerce? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So Naveen sir will put this in group also. Anyone else having any doubt? Anything you guys want to say here? Anyone else? Any expert, like, you know, Akhilesh sir, Naveen ma'am, want to add on and put any point here? Same thing we'll write in the group also.
Yes, yeah. Yes, I'll do that. Divya and Shivangi, they have improved a lot. I am very happy for them.
Yeah, even Ansika also spoke well today. It was really good and I maintained. Mayank also tried well today. You have a better network compared to yesterday. And I know everybody having a basic essential fight these days. So obviously you are trying your best. And we are really on a good platform. I don't feel like you guys are not here in class. So it's a good. Anyone else? Should we close the session? Rimji ma'am?
Yes, I think we can close this session. And in the next class, I hope they, you know, speak without looking at things and, you know, try to remember it and understand it and then say.
Yes, eye contact. Just see your camera, your face in, like, you know.
Yes.
In your laptop or phone, whichever you are using it. And try using the laptop if possible.
Yes.
And use the Wi-Fi also. Okay, thank you everyone. That's it from my side. Sir.
Okay. Bye, guys. I hope Naveen sir and Akhilesh sir will put everything on the group. Hope this session was helpful for you, and we'll post everything on the group. Bye, guys. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Bye.